A team of scientists in Japan have just discovered that a volcano in the country produced a recent eruption so large that it was in fact larger than one of the Yellowstone Supervolcano's three famous climactic eruptions. This eruption occurred a mere 7,308 years ago at a volcano known as the Kikai Caldera. Previous estimates placed the size of Kikai's caldera-forming eruption as 138 times larger than the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens, which translated to 180 cubic kilometers of ejected rock. In contrast, the new estimate suggests instead that it ejected 394.5 cubic kilometers of tephra, increasing its size by more than a factor of 2. Looking at the volcano in question, this estimate doesn't even sound all that unreasonable considering what its climactic eruption left behind. As in 5284 BCE, the Kikai caldera violently exploded, releasing approximately the same volume of ash every second that the 2021 eruption of the Cumbre Vieja volcano produced during the entirety of its 85-day-long eruption. As a plume of ash rapidly shot upwards to a height of 43 kilometers or 141,000 feet, part of the eruption column was too dense to be propelled upwards by a buoyant column of air, causing it to collapse back to the ground. This generated superheated pyroclastic flows which raced outwards in all directions at a speed exceeding 200 kilometers per hour, creating a layer which hovered above the water while another layer sunk into the ocean. A 40-meter-high tsunami was generated by the displacement of water these two pyroclastic flows created, moving at a speed of 500 kilometers per hour to strike and devastate regional coastlines, flooding more than 5 kilometers inland in some areas. As the pyroclastic flows continued outwards, they incinerated all vegetation and animal life they touched, wiping out life on large sections of the islands of Kuroshima, Yakushima, Meijoshima, Tanegashima, and beyond. Flows traveled furthest to the north, incinerating everything on large swaths of the island of Kyushu, almost reaching the modern Sakurajima volcano and traveling up to 92 kilometers distant. Tens of thousands of humans were likely killed, and as the eruption continued, the sky turned black while also raining down thick amounts of ash. Tokyo received 10 centimeters thick of ash, Osaka received 22 centimeters, Kochi received 31 centimeters, Kagoshima received 65 centimeters, and the southern tip of Kyushu received more than a meter thick of ash over the next 16 hours. Then, due to the large amount of material which had erupted, the magma chamber of Kikai had become largely emptied. Now no longer able to hold the massive overlying rock, a 21-kilometer or 13-mile-wide swath of ground collapsed downwards by 1,000 meters or 3,280 feet to form a massive caldera. What had once been a 180-square-kilometer island with a summit 800 meters above sea level had been almost completely destroyed, with the only remnants being the Iwo Jima and Takeshima Islands. The eruption I just described is referred to as the 5284 BCE Akahuya eruption and represents the single largest explosive eruption to ever occur from the Kikai volcano. However, it was not the only time this large caldera produced a similarly powerful explosive eruption. Kikai also produced another VEI-7 eruption 170,000 years ago, only to be followed by a low-end VEI-6 eruption 86,000 years ago. As you can see, Kikai generally has a large repose between two caldera-forming eruptions, meaning that even with a dozen fairly small eruptions Kikai has produced since the 1990s, the volcano is unlikely to generate another highly powerful eruption for another 30,000 years, if not longer. Because of the sheer power the Akahoya eruption had, and the fact that Kikai has produced multiple VEI-7 eruptions, I have seen several scientific papers classify the Kikai complex as a supervolcano. However, I am not sure that I completely agree with this designation of Kikai as a supervolcano. Don't get me wrong, Kikai does seem to behave in supervolcano-like ways, including the fact that it has a very large submarine rhyolite lava dome and has produced multiple very powerful eruptions. However, much like Italy's Campi Flegrei volcano or Russia's Polzhetka caldera, I believe that the Kikai caldera falls into a middle ground designation between a stratovolcano that has a large caldera and a true supervolcano. It is for this reason that I am not calling the Kikai volcano as a supervolcano, but rather a large caldera complex.